In this illustration, we'll study about no intensity points on a wall. Here, we are given that the figure shows two point sources S1 and S2 separated by a distance d which is equal to 3 times the wavelength of light. And we are given that both sources are placed at a distance L from the wall with d very small compared to L and are having equal intensities. We are required to find all points on wall where light intensity will be 0. We know intensity is equal to 0 at points of destructive interference. And destructive interference take place at positions where a path difference is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, that is odd multiple of lambda by 2. So here if we analyze it again, and these are the two sources S1 and S2, and from these sources if we consider a point P on wall, which is say located at an angular position theta from point O, the center of this screen, then we can see if D is the separation between the sources, then if we drop a perpendicular from S2 to line S1P, then this would be the path difference between the two waves approaching point P. So in this situation, if this angle is theta, here we can write the value of path difference at point P is this path difference we can write as d cos theta. And when this path difference is an odd multiple of lambda by 2 at point P, destructive interference take place and the intensity of light at point P will be 0. So all the points can be considered as d cos theta is equals to lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, and 5 lambda by 2, because when this angle theta becomes 90, path difference will become 0. And at this point O, we can see the path difference is equals to 3 lambda, as we are given that d is 3 lambda. So as we move away from O, there will be a nearest point from O where path difference is 5 lambda by 2, then 3 lambda by 2, then lambda by 2. So there are 3 points we are getting along the line if we move away from O. Then in this situation we can write, the first point is d cos theta where it is lambda by 2. This implies the value of theta we are getting is cos inverse of lambda by 2d, and if we substitute d as 3 lambda, this is cos inverse of 1 by 6, this is theta 1, and another we can write d cos theta 2 is equals to where path difference is 3 lambda by 2, which implies the value of theta 2 we are getting is cos inverse of 3 lambda by 2d, and if we put d is equals to 3 lambda, this will be cos inverse of if you substitute d as 3 lambda, it is 1 by 2. And another one is d cos theta 3 is equals to, if we write it as 5 lambda by 2, this implies the value of theta 3 we are having is cos inverse of 5 lambda by 2d. And if we substitute d as 3 lambda, this will be cos inverse of 5 by 6. So these are the 3 angles at which if we consider a point P from the center of a screen, at these angular distances from center of a screen, there will be 0 intensity. And we can observe that at a particular point P, if it is located at a distance R from point O, then if we consider a circle of radius R on this screen, everywhere the path difference remains same due to the two sources, so the intensity will also remain same. So there will be three concentric rings, or you can say ring-shaped fringes obtained where the intensity will be zero. So here we can write three dark circular fringes are obtained on a screen, which is actually a wall in this case, that is the result of this problem.